Okay. 8 o'clock, and all is well. At least I like to think 8 o'clock all is well. Here we go. This is going to be our first, I should probably fade the music out the rest of the way, you know? I mean, we could keep it going technically, but anyway. We're going to go back to the spooky space sounds. Jennifer, how are you doing this evening, lady? Good to see you in the chat. I'm going to be like looking over here for the chat instead of like over here today, because it's like I've been streaming so many console games, especially the Nintendo stuff on the Switch. It's like I haven't streamed a PC game in a while, and I keep forgetting. It's like I got to move a bunch of stuff around when I do that. My layout gets a little bit strange. But we're going to see what happens here. Yeah, I'm doing okay. I had a decent day at work. I was supposed to deliver a chalk talk for somebody today on, like, what was I going to talk about? Oh, performance troubleshooting with extended events. One of my favorite topics ever. There were just, like, a couple people showed up, and the people who really wanted to be there couldn't show up, so it was like we just decided to reschedule anyway. This is one of my recurring customers anyway, so one of my dedicated customers, so I'm going to talk to them again next week regardless, and we're going to sit down and hopefully learn some new things and have some fun. That's the goal when I try to build these sessions and talks and stuff, is to try and have some fun. All right, but yeah, I'm doing okay. Trying to see what else is going on with my streaming software. Where are we at? I might have to jump from OBS to something else, because I'm starting to see some cracks in the facade here with certain things that I want to do and its ability to function at not just as a piece of streaming software, but as like a streaming platform. I'm wondering if there might be something better I can use. I don't know, but we'll find out. We will find out one way or the other. Okay, so we're going to play Observation. This is a... When I looked it up, I thought it was like a horror game. At least that's what I remember from the first time that I saw this game being played. I remember it as a horror game. It's billed as a puzzle adventure game. So that right there is... I mean, that's my jam. Puzzle adventure games? I am all over puzzle adventure games. I'll play that for years. I'm more than happy to do that. So I got out my adventure notebook, just in case. I just realized I don't have anything to write with. That's going to be a problem. If I actually have to take notes in my notebook, I need to write something down, and I have nothing to write with. You know what? We'll wait and see. We'll wait and see when I have to actually start taking notes and writing stuff down and remembering things. Because if I do, then we're going to start having some real fun. How well will Dave's memory work tonight? We don't know. But we're going to see. All right. Observation. Let's skip on over to the gameplay. Ooh. Spooky space stuff. All right. I'm in a new game. I took a couple seconds to look through the game options. And I looked under controls, and I'm already terrified. Pitch, yaw, roll. We're going to be flying. These are flight controls. We're going to be flying in space. I'm not good with that. I am very poor at flight mechanics. So we're going to see how well that works out. Hey, Geocache in chat. I'd say, how are you doing? But I know how you're doing because I talked to you like less than an hour ago. Unless something has changed in the last hour and you want to tell me about it. This is one of those games. Adjust the gamma. Okay. Not visible. Barely visible. Fully visible. Adjust until the center image is barely visible. Well, how... Okay. For me, that's barely visible, but I'm looking at what's going out on broadcast. It's hard to tell. I'm gonna go with the actually with the OBS screen on this one rather than the ones in front of me, because that looks pretty good to me. So I think we will go. We'll go with that for now. If we need to change it later, we can change it. You don't see anything in the middle? All right. Let's try right about there. Let me know how that works for you. Okay. Cool. We'll go with that. And yes, E, I do have the adventure notebook out. I'm going to actually, let me grab something to write with real quick. Yeah, all my writing instruments are over at the work desk. All right. Now we are prepared. We are prepared for an adventure game. So let's do it. Subtitles, yes. Sync to audio, yes. Okay. Here we go. I got no idea what's coming. I mean, I kind of have an idea what's coming. I have seen a gameplay of this before. Scary Game Squad played it a couple years ago. But I honestly, I don't remember a whole lot of it. So. I watched about 10 minutes of this on Tuesday night. Seems stressful. Ooh. Well, we're going to find out.
Houston, do you copy? Houston, come in.
Houston, do something. That's not looking good.
We've had some sort of accident, collision, or something, maybe. I don't know. The station is spinning, but I can't tell if it's falling towards Earth. I can't get a visual from here. Josh, Ailsa, someone, report in.
That doesn't look good. I got no response from anybody right now.
Ah, shit. Sam? Sam, are you there? Come on. Okay, Sam. I need you to give me admin access. Enable voice authentication.
What is going on here? Analyze. De-analyze waveform. Voice print errors detected. Accept or reject. Oh, wow. I mean. Wait, so we're the AI. Okay. So we got it. Okay. Oh boy. Accept. I guess. Accept. Okay. I guess we accepted. Hey, Corzin with the raid. Thank you, sir. Much appreciated. How'd the trial go? Are you there? Online status request urgent. M efficient systems administration maintenance online. I don't know what I'm doing. Controls unlocked. Hold R to enter response mode. No active objective. Oh, Sam, systems administration and maintenance. Okay, cool, we got it.
I am here.
Oh, thank God. Okay. Now Okay.
We're getting somewhere, right? We're on a spinning space station that may be crashing.
I'm going to relocate you to the Horizon Utility Hub in Module 9. That should give you access to limited system diagnostics.
Camera node connection. Okay.
Great. Listen, I'm stuck in the Horizon airlock in Module 11. I need to get into 9, but I'm not sure if it's safe to open this hatch door. Can you give me hull and pressure diagnostics on Module 9?
How do I do that? Oh, good lord. Okay. Module 9. Pressure safe, power low, hull contacts, true system links connected. Alright. Do I need to click on anything else? EAS arm. Module EAS 09. Okay, back. I just did that, right? Okay. No, that's not what I want. Resume game. Do thing. Module EAS 11. Because she said she's in 11, right? System links connected. Detailed diagnostics offline. Core links restarting. What am I doing here? Oh, I need to respond. Ah, there we go.
Module 9 is fully pressurized.
Okay, that's good. Good. Are the adjacent contact points from 9 intact?
Hull contacts, true.
Module 9, hull contact points to adjacent modules read true.
Good, we're still connected.
Okay.
Something is vibrating, Sam. Can you check the hull contact points on the other modules?
Okay, let's do that. Module 11. Contact points are true for there. Module 10. Contact, all contacts false for 10. Let's check the other one real quick. Let's check 8. All contacts are true for there. So let's just report the negative. Let's go to 10 and say... Here's the problem.
Module 10, hull contact points to 12 read false, suggesting that module 12 is no longer securely attached to the station.
Shit. I think Josh might have been in module 12. Okay.
Sucks to be Josh.
I'm coming through tonight.
All right, come on in.
Sam, the hatch door is jammed shut.
What the... Is that a puzzle I have to solve?
See if you can restore power. Sam.
RA 2 degrees 42 minutes 21 seconds declination. 83 degrees 32 minutes 400.
What is that?
Wait,
noise?
What? The hell was that? Bring her... Fucking hell, what are we doing? I don't think I can click on anything other than accept. Sorry, lady, I don't know what I just did, but I sure as hell did it. She's just like, cause I'm free, free floating. No response, no diagnostics, no control. Yep, we're here in the old cutscene.
Blacked out. This isn't good. This isn't good. Sam, run your self-diagnostic procedure. What errors are you showing?
That's great. That's a great question. Here, hold on. Relocation network error diagnose. Module relocation network is non-operational. Crew assist required.
Relocation functions are offline. I require auto routing to access module cameras.
Okay. I can manually relocate you, but once I get out of here, I'll get your systems up and running.
Okay. Memory core. Percent degradation? Good God. I would get fired for something like that. 93%? Man, we are in sad shape. Well, watch. Now, 4 will be fine. Nope. I was kind of hoping. 97%. That's the worst one. I was kind of hoping. Dude, do you not get rate 5 in space? Is that what we're talking about here? Come on. A little redundancy wouldn't hurt. Okay, response.
The main memory core has been corrupted. I have lost significant station data.
Okay. So most of your system links and data logs are gone. Sam, you will need to scan, download, and recover as much data as you can. We need to get you back to your old self.
Alright. Crew tracker error. This ought to be good. Let's see. What do I... Okay, crew identification network. Attempting connection. Connection failed. Location sensor array. Anything? Hey, we're good. Tracker power. Nice. Vitals and live parameter sensors. Please tell me this one works. Good. Except we don't have... Why would the ID network fail? See how I just automatically go into troubleshooting mode? I'm trying to remember I'm playing a game and I don't actually have to fix this. All right, let's see.
The connection between crew tracker functionality and SAM OS has been severed.
So it's working, but the link is cut. I'll need to reconnect it in Central. Josh? Alright. May? Anyone? Shit. Okay. Yeah. I can't get out of here. The hatch controls aren't working. It might be a safety lockdown. You'll have to override the hatch from Module 9. Okay. I'm auto-routing you back to Module 9.
So,
movement should be online now. Run a test.
I don't want to get ahead of myself here, but if we're unable to track members of the crew, are we also unable to identify members of the crew? And her voice print was screwed up, now, which could have been part of the interference, but is she really who she says she is? This is a space adventure game. I know, like I said, I might be getting ahead of myself here, but I'm starting to wonder already. Okay, controls unlocked, WASD to move camera. Oh, controls and objectives. Camera system links, run a test. Okay, let's move the camera around. CO2 refill, combustion unit, good God, what is all of this? Hatch control, hey, look at there. All right, there's a thing down here. It's Wheatley! Flight connection sphere, laptop. Wait, can I actually, hang on, can I actually control some of this? There's this over here. That's module 8. I'm in 9. 10's over there. 11's over there, but I can't see it from here. I can't respond to anything. Current angle ABC, can I change that? No. Can I do something with some of this? Are those like QR codes?
Camera cycling should be active as well. Check the other cameras.
Q and E to cycle between cameras, okay. Voop! Hey! Okay, so that's where she's at, is in there. So I need to somehow get this open.
Great. I can see your live feed updating from here.
Hatch control!
There should be a system links reset procedure document on the wall somewhere in there. Find it and scan it. Your scan range is limited, so use your camera zoom to get closer.
Oh, scroll wheel to zoom and that to scan. I can't see that from here. Sphere modification bay. Maybe it's one of the other cameras. Is it that? Document. Zoom to interact. Hey! SAM OS procedure. System link reset. That's the one, baby. Shows terminal input code that allows only perform after a full reset. Warning, procedure will require a reconnection to all system links station-wide. Okay.
Okay. That should be reinstalling the system link interface.
Okay, great.
Use your cameras to locate the hatch controls and any other integrated systems and equipment.
Any other integrated systems and equipment. Okay. So I can... Oh, laptop add system link. Pairing. We got Bluetooth on this thing. Pairing 133. Do I actually have to put in 133? 133? Oh, yeah, I do have to put it in. Okay.
Looks like that's working.
But it won't let me use a numpad. Add another. Okay. Let's do offline connection sphere. No, off. It's offline. I can't do that. What else could I do? Sphere notification bay. Let's go back to that other camera. See what else I can see. Can't do anything with that. I can do that laptop. Can I not zoom in? I mean, she said add another, but it's not letting me. Maybe I need to be not this, but here. Nope, can't do that. Good, add another, she said. What else can I add? Should I be able to add... Hang on. Power caddy. Zoom to interact. Turn off? I don't think I want to do that. Do I? I feel like I don't. I feel like that'd be a bad idea. Maybe I can add the hatch controls. Let's do that. Add system link. There we go. 334.
Your system link interface to open the EAS-11 airlock.
Okay. Open hatch or schematic. Let's look at the schematic real quick. I can't look at the schematic because it's not letting me do it.
That's it. It's open. phone, I'm out. Good work, Sam. Okay. Let's get this up and running. Josh? I don't know if you can hear me, but...
I hate these things. Josh, if you're in EAS Module 12, then stay put. The hull connection isn't secure, and most of our systems are underpowered. I'll work something out. Josh? Houston? Anyone?
I mean, if we had a collision, I doubt we're going to be talking to anybody anytime soon. I've got like no controls right now. Okay. Enter the SAM OS systems at any time by pressing space.
You can now relocate to any module and view its camera feeds. In the EAS arm at least. Try it now. Find that fire, Sam.
Find that fire? Okay. Okay, to 8. I hear it. Okay, it's not an 8. 6? Nope, nothing in 6. 5? There. 4? I think we found it. Oh, controls or objectives? Find the fire.
There is a fire out of control in EAS-4.
Shit, I'm on my way.
Okay, on your way to what? I mean, can I do anything from here? Is there like some kind of automated suppression system? Something I can interact with. I'm not seeing anything. Because I'm guessing I don't want to open the hatch. Right?
Sam? The hatch in EAS-6 is locked down. Can you get it open for me?
That's where we're going. The hatch in EAS-6. Okay, so I gotta be in EAS-5 and get the hatch to 6 open somehow. I can't tell if that's... Yeah, that's 6. Add system link. 423. Pairing, system linked, open hatch. All right,
relocate to EAS-3. I'll need your help when I get there.
Okay, here I am. Now what? What are we doing? I hope you got a plan.
controls to your system links, but wait for my signal.
Okay. EAS 4. Where were those hatch links? It's over here somewhere. There it is. Hatch control, add system link. 2, 4, 3. Pairing, system linked.
Fire suppression override. Dr. Emma Fisher. Okay, Sam. I need you to get ready and open the door. On three.
Oh boy.
Are you ready? One. Two. That's it. Come on!
I tried to go like right on three. I'm glad I got it at least close enough. Give me camera control, maybe. Can I get up in here? Can't get any higher. Where are the vents? There are the vents. Extractor vents. 3, 4, 4. System linked. On. There they go.
Dissipating now.
Yay! We fixed it!
How bad is it?
Damage reports. Rack damage. Zoom to respond.
The rack units have been damaged beyond any functional use.
Overall, that's not too bad. Considering.
We're stranded in space. We need all the equipment we can get.
What was the source, Sam? We need to stop it happening again.
I'm guessing that this looks like it's faulty over here, this panel right here. I think. Medical storage. Okay, not. I don't see anything else to interact with here. I really think it's that panel, but it's not letting me. I can't get any closer to it. Maybe I need to cycle to a different camera. And get closer. That was just graphics. I thought the way the light changed, I thought there was something important there. Yeah, it's not letting me. There's no, what do you call it? A and D, what's that? Map data missing. Okay, never mind that. Return to last location. I mean, it's this, right? Is there something specific on this that I should be looking at? Not that I can tell.
Residue on panel LFE1 indicates a potential source.
What? That's just a blank plate. Let me see. Something is coming out of the side.
Okay.
What's that?
Ooh, don't touch that, don't touch that, don't touch that, don't touch that, don't touch that.
There's maybe something in storage above that's leaking.
Keep it away from your face, keep it away from your face. Crew request status report. Severe stress warning EAS 12.
There is significant stress being applied to EAS 12. Immediate separation recommended.
Okay. Where are we going now? I'm assuming EAS 12.
If there is anyone in Module 12, make yourself known now. We are about to jettison the module. Someone, please respond.
Yeah, we're in cutscene territory again. I got nothing.
Okay. Sam, get ready for the separation procedure.
How?
First, process my authorization code and give me a security override key.
Okay.
14424133324.
Please tell me that was right.
2903419.
Got it. Inputting now. Hurry, Sam. Target the jets and push the module away safely. Sam, target the jets in the correct sequence.
What's the correct sequence?
We don't have much time. Go, go, go.
Wait a minute.
Fire them in the correct order, the module might tear off.
Okay, I don't know. Got it. Sequence 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh boy. Not here. I can't really see anything. Solar array structural damage detected.
The primary solar panel array on the EAS arm has been torn off.
That explains the lack of power.
Jefferson, I told you it was stressful. You were right. You were right. I never doubted you. I never doubted you for a second. Good lord. Is this all I can see? Okay, primary solar array torn off. Is this a different one here then? Or is this the same one? Already, okay, responded. Already responded with that. Can I see anything here?
EAS 12 is still tethered with unusual structural damage.
It's like a hole has been cut out of it. What would do that?
Hell if I know. Okay, already reported that. Alright, I can't see anything else. Feed sequence. Can I go to... Alright, yeah.
Spun off course. Damage doesn't look too severe. Just isolated sections.
Not seeing... Oh, that's messed up. I'm irked that it took me as long to figure out that sequence puzzle as it did. It was just getting used to the controls for how to do it. I thought I was hitting the right stuff and I wasn't. Is this where I have to tell her I picked up a fault in the AE-35 unit?
The RU arm upper modules are badly damaged.
The damage seems to be localized to the upper part of the arms. I'm going to connect to the distance cam. We should see where we are above Earth and if we've lost any altitude.
Okie dokie. Oh boy. Well, now we know why Houston wasn't responding. Do I really want to tell her this? Right ascension 2 degrees, 42 minutes, 21 seconds. Declination, positive 83 degrees, 32 minutes, 24 seconds. Yeesh.
I brought you here. It seems.
What? Why?
Black box entry 4441, signal accepted. Message received, coordinates set. And see error.
I don't know
either. What do we know right now? We know we're stranded. Achievement unlocked. How did we get here? Yeah, that's a thing. That was the intro. That whole bit was just the intro to this game. Holy crap. This is going to be interesting. That was just the intro. Okay. Alright, game. You want it? You got it. Let's do this. I am ready when you are. I'm psyched up now. I'm looking forward to this. I wasn't sure how this was going to go, but... It isn't really a medal, I suppose, but I don't know. Cool so far. Cool so far, definitely. Unbelievable. Is it going to kick us back to the same spot or before the crash? That's a good question. I do not know. Like I said, I have seen a playthrough of this before, but I don't remember very much at all. I remember it had something to do with Saturn. I didn't remember that this is how we got to Saturn. Oh, that's right. Yeah, with the external camera. I remember looking through it and freaking out, but that was all I saw. Well, here we are. Here we are. We're the princes of the universe.
I restarted your core systems. Not making any sense. And to be quite honest, I'm fucking terrified right now. Anyway.
Aren't we all? That should come across just fine.
Okay.
All good.
So, Sam, here's the deal. I'm stuck in the EAS arm for now. I think it's related to power. A lot of the hatches are fully knocked out. So, I'm going to try something different.
Okay. Is that my floaty ball? Are we gonna start flying now?
That's audio, at least. Almost there. Just a sec.
Yeesh.
Shit, that's not it. There we go.
Oh boy.
Okay, Sam. I have rigged a connection sphere for you to use.
Okay.
I'll be able to take control of this and fly around the station. It'll let you
Is that a good idea?
And it'll let you wirelessly connect to non-station devices, like laptops. Looking good.
Oh boy.
Okay. Let's see if you can move it. Fly over to me. Great. Now turn around 180 degrees to face me and fly back.
Okay. Use mouse to aim the sphere drift. Oh, thank God I can. Thank you, Jeebus. If I had to use keyboard controls for this, we were going to be in major trouble.
Good. Good. There are more controls for translation and rotation, but I'll let you figure them out. You should still be able to identify objects and relay information to me like any other camera. Right now.
Yep. Laptop. Oh, no response for the laptop, huh? No response for that. So what am I supposed to respond to now? Sphere, offline connection sphere?
Connection sphere is offline.
Okay, great. That works. Now, you can release yourself from the sphere and return to your main OS just like before. Try it now.
So, to disconnect from sphere...
Sphere tracking is online, so its location will be displayed on your station map.
Oh, okay, I see it.
You can either quick connect directly from your map, or you can use a nearby module camera to access it. Reconnect to your sphere now.
Okay. I could just click this, but let's try the camera version. Because I want to make sure that I understand how to do this.
Right.
Possess.
Sphere connection systems.
That really... Did that really just say possess? Connect to the laptop? There was another laptop, wasn't there? Oh, this is like, hang on. There we go. So hold this to connect. Attempt to download whatever data is left. WS cycle entries. Okay. Well, that's the only thing I got. Okay, so I got that. Disconnect.
Great. Can't believe that all actually worked. Right. So, the rest of the station is dark, and the horizon arm is running on emergency power.
Ooh, you can strafe.
The solar panels give us next to nothing this far from the sun. However, we do have an experimental fusion reactor on board, the EFR. If that can generate enough power, we can maybe get the universal hatches open. See what you can do. I'll try to find a way to contact the rest of the crew.
Oh, sure, absolutely. That sounds like a wonderful idea. We are stranded in space way beyond Earth's orbit, and we've got a fusion reactor. Has it got a pole start? Let's try that, shall we? Good God. Okay. Access EAS-01. How the heck do I get to EAS-01? Can I just go there? Oh, I can. So I can go here with the camera, but it's not necessarily going to let me. Environment sensor? Is there something I can do with this? Nope, guess not. Alright, so it's going to let me come here with the camera, but it won't necessarily get me what I need. Yes. Okay. So I could be here with the camera. Oh wait, what's up here? Document. Zoom to interact. Let's check it out. Boop. Oh boy. Experimental fusion reactor. Standard LOS and ROS electrical power systems provide a safe supply of uninterrupted electrical power for observation. Over the course of the mission, however, this will switch over to an experimental system, the EFR. Experimental fusion reactor is a compact deuterium reactor designed for use onboard orbital platforms. As far as an experimental device, it will come online as a part of Observation's wider mission, whatever that is, and will serve as an energy source for many of its experiments, although only a fraction of its potential power will be used. So you say. Inside the EFR, superheated deuterium gas is held within an immensely powerful magnetic field where fusion occurs. Basically, we're lighting a star. Device is fully automated, but in the event of emergency plasma flow, can be controlled by local SAM systems via electromagnetic conduits. Foreshadowing, foreshadowing, foreshadowing. In the event of an emergency, the EFR can be safely removed from observation systems by SAM or by a crew member, and existing electrical power systems will return online. Okay, fine. So we're going to light it, something's going to go wrong, and then we're going to have to jettison the thing. Storage bag. Can't interact with that. VHD, is that overhead? Let's cycle cameras real quick to see what else is in this module. Patch panel of some sort. What does that say? Send email to Ailsa. Okay. Somebody's notes. Okay, so I know I'm going to have to fly here with the sphere. I can see that. I don't think there's anything else to do on this end of the module. That's the document we already read. That's open there. Gotta wonder what that is. And there's this. Ooh, laptops. Can I connect to either of these? No, because they're not powered. All right. Well, ooh, another document. Hold the scan. Experiment order 244. Alternative power in low light positions. EASA and USES would like to continue the explanation of exploration of alternative station power when solar panels are not reliable or in low-light environments. It is important that the sample data of each test run is regularly collated. At no point should the EFR be switched to station mode without an executive order and should remain on the test circuits. Nominal range, experimental range. God, I hope I don't actually have to do anything with that data because I cannot read that. All right, let's see where we're at. What time is it anyway? Let's see what we got. Oh, it's not even 9 yet. We got plenty of time. Let us continue to explore. All right. So we got that. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything else going on here. All right. There's a little, plenty of dust on this camera, though. But all right. Let's go back to here. So I've got to fly through 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. I'm just going to write that down real quick because I got this notebook out and I got to write something down. So we're going through 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. All right. Because I may be a ship's AI, but I don't think I have GPS. So I will get lost. Okay. It is Sphere 30. Possess. I love how it says possess. Bing. All right. EAS 9. Let's go. 8. Let's see, which way is which? That is... That's just an exit. I don't see a number on that door, so I'm going to assume... That's this one. 8. Still in 8. What's this over here? Six. Cool, we're going the right way. No!
Sam, was that you?
I mean... I think I hit it a little too hard. Must have had a self-destruct mechanism. I don't think I hit it that hard. What the F was that?
Oh, okay. I've switched off a few of the systems. Seems to have helped.
Yeah, we'll just cut life support. We'll be alright.
We need the EFR online.
Okay, I'm assuming... I think that door said 3. Here's 3. Okie dokie. This is probably 2. I think this is 2. Should be 2. Yeah. Here, crew bunk. Okay. Well, what's this? All right. That was a thing. Hatch control. Hi. I can't do a thing. Do I need to open this from the other side? Do I need to open this from 2? Let's try that. That's 1. Yeah, I think that's what I gotta do. Add system link. I appreciate the fact that it hasn't gone over... Wait, close hatch? That's not what I want to do. I want to open hatch. Wait a minute. So if that's... Wait a minute. If that's 3 and it's open, am I in 3 just facing the wrong way? Hang on. How am I... I told you this is going to be awkward. Where's my buddy at? There he is. Possess. You are mine. Where is... Is that not where I just came from? Did I miss something here? There's that. Should be this, right? crew bunk, food preparation area. Okay. Ooh, laptops I can do stuff with. And well, I can't do anything with them because they got no power. So that's four. Wait, is this three down here? Or is this two? No, this is four. I was in here before. I was in here. All right, so back out here. Oh, did I just need to go straight through here? And I got all turned around. Yeah, nice. Okay, fine. Oh, that's not what I want. All right, EAS 1. This is not... Hatch control? Can I not do anything with you? SAM OS. All right, I guess I got to open it from 1. There it is, EAS 2. Three, four, two. System linked, locked. I'm assuming the schematic has something to do with that. Required schematic data not found. Hold, start connection. Draw connection, hold, view schematic. Exit schematic. So I can't respond to that. So I'm assuming the schematic for this is going to be here somewhere. The question is where? Document zoomed in. Is that the one we read earlier? Yeah, with data recovered. So probably. I mean, do we think that the schematic information that we need would probably be somewhere in this module? Or would it be elsewhere? Let's take a look at... Hold on. I'm wondering if there's a way we can somehow get these laptops working. Like, some power these up. And maybe there's some information on these that we can use. I mean, I don't see any plugs or anything. Maybe, hang on, maybe from two. Oh, there's a laptop, like, right next to the door. Hold on. Let's, I possess you. You are mine. Add system link. 3, 2, 1. Contact. Hold to connect. EAS hatch schematic. Alright. That's what I want. That is what I want. Oh, come on. Hold on. You should probably see a professional about that laugh. Oh, I've seen many a professional. Now, all they say is, you scare me, get out. Okay, so I know for a fact I'm not going to remember any of this. So, it is time to figure out how to use the camera on my phone. Boop. Okay. L1 EAS hatch open. L2 EAS hatch close. L3 EAS hatch unlock and L4 EAS hatch lock. Okay, so I have to unlock it and then open it. Okay. Come on, phone. Let me zoom. All right. So let's get out of this. Nice. Use schematic in camera mode. F, switch to module camera. Oh, I need to go back to go back to one first. Use schematic in camera mode. Okay. Zip. Oh boy. Okay. Let's see. Where am I at? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. In the second column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold start connection. So here. And then 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. Unlock. Dig it. And from here, I'm just gonna go root and it won't let me turn any further. We're gonna shortcut. Hey, here we are. Now, I'm going to take a wild guess. Experimental fusion reactor. Oh, boy. Why do I get the feeling that this is going to get real intense real quick? It's been nice knowing you. I am about to kill everybody on this station. Here we go. If we're going to do it, doing it with an experimental fusion reactor is the way to go. All right.
I have no idea how that thing works. It was something Josh was working on. You're pretty much on your own, I'm afraid. Do what you can, just get it online.
Oh boy. All right. So, move cursor, adjust magnet strength. Eject plasma. Was there a procedure for this that I was supposed to get? Because I'm not seeing like a manual or anything here. Yeah, caution. Tell me about it. Let's go back out here. Days before the dark. That's about where we're at right now. How apropos. Most definitely apropos for the situation, my good sir. Oh my god, what am I doing? I think it's this one. So how do I... Wait a minute. Do I just... Online EFR. Can I read if I get closer? Experiment. Order 244. Level of... I can't read that. Yeah, I know. Back it up. Do I really need... I don't think I need that. I don't think I need that. I'd like to believe that I do, but I think I don't. I think I'm making this more... Slow down, man. Slow down. I think I'm making this more complicated than it needs to be. Yeah, because it looks... Because right now, this is just friggin' easy, right? Okay, WS adjust magnet strength. Plasma magnet. Enable containment. This music got real intense real quick. I think we got to figure out... how do I move cursor, select, adjust magnet strength, What do I adjust the magnet strength to? That is what my question is. Okay, so containment's on. WS, adjust magnet strength. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to click on this and move and adjust with W and S, and it's not doing anything. Do I need to turn the containment back off? Redirect power? No. If I inject plasma, I have a... Why do I feel like if I do that, this thing is gonna, just going to lose its mind? Plasma magnet. Okay. I mean, that's the only thing that's lighting up right now is the inject plasma button. Just push buttons and until something happens. That's how I learned SQL. Do stuff and see what breaks. Sheesh. All right, inject plasma. Oh, boy. Okay, so this one, get that. No. Get that in there. This one's got to go. This one's got to go. Not like that. Get in there. This one. Get out? No. That one out? That one's got to go in, I think. Yeah, this one going in? I gotta shape this somehow. System timeout 12. Whoa, 12 seconds. Okay. So that's right there. Okay, it's gonna shut down in a sec. Which is fine. Okay, so this I need to. Alright. We're okay. We didn't destroy the world. I thought we might. But. Okay, so this. Bring it in. A little bit further. Whoop, not like that. This is. Out. Yeah, we gotta bring that out. Right there. Good. Bring that out. Good. Bring that. Nope. Out. Just a bit. Bring this out. And bring this in some. Oh, we're almost there. I think we got it. Bring that in just a bit. Whoop. There and redirect power. Boink. No? Offline? What did I. Oh, it resets all of them too. Good lord. Alright, let's try it again. We can get this. Alright, inject the plasma. Magnet strength up. Come on, magnet strength up. Right about there. This one. A little bit further. Whoop, not quite so far. This one, back it out. Right about there. This one, back it out just a little bit. Whoop, just a little bit. That one, back it out. This one, back it out. No, back it out, Dave. Come on, you can do it. Hey, look at that. Hey, we got it, right? Wait, it only said number 2 was safe. Oh, I gotta do it until it reads safe. Oh, come on. All right, let's do it again. Okay, number 1, come on. Go, back it out. Back it 7. We're almost there. Oh, I'm going the wrong way with it. Shoot. Sorry, we got 15 seconds. Right there, and this one, back it out. 8 seconds. Redirect power. Yee-haw.
I'm running low on oxygen, so let's get a move on.
Running low on oxygen, so where are we going?
Sam? Sam, is that you making that noise?
Nope. I'm not doing anything! I swear I'm not doing anything.
I can see it, Sam. Can you see it? It's... I can't explain it. I can feel it.
What the hell? I'm not so sure I want to proceed. What is this thing? I got nothing else. Good Lord, what were those? Replay. Hang on. Circle, circle, dot, dot. Whatever that is. Move the circle to the middle. Circle, dot. The number 4 fork. And circle to the middle. Okay, circle, fork. Circle to the middle. The hell? Circle again. Pyramid. Take a right. Circle with a hexagon. So this one again. Pyramid. Hang a right. And that one. I think. This is like phase 2. Like the reactor was phase 1, this is like phase 2. Here we go. Circle dot. Reverse check. Pyramid. Okay. Circle dot. Reverse check. And pyramid. SA2. Oh man, I hope I haven't had to been writing these things down. Oh boy. Alright. SA2. Probably should have been. I told you don't touch that black grease. Or red grease, lady.
power is back, but the hatch to Universal is still offline. I need you to find out what the problem is.
Yikes.
Give me a systems diagnostic.
Okie dokie. She said Universal, right? So I'm guessing that means that's the UN one. Okay.
Module UN1 hull contact points to EAS3 are unresponsive.
This sounds bad. Okay, so the power is fine, but the hull connection points are misaligned. That we can fix. I can't get them open from here, but you should be able to reclamp the contact points from outside. Looks like you're going on your first spacewalk, Sam. Before you go outside, though, we need to update your sphere firmware to allow for exterior use. To upgrade, you'll have to scan the barcodes in EAS 11. Once you're fully updated, we'll get you outside. I'm granting you EVA permission now. The internal airlock hatch is now open.
Good lord. Alright. This is exactly what I was afraid of. We're going on a walk. Oh my god. Alright. So I need to get to EAS 11? Yeah, scan sphere HVC codes in EAS 11. Okay, so I'm in 9 now. Which ways? Hang on. So 11 was over here. Yeah. Is that? I'm sorry, that's scary. What the heck? Sphere upgrade codes. Okay. Document hold the scan. Hey, sheep. Glad to see you made it, buddy. Sphere upgrade procedure. Allow for maximum mobility and protection from the vacuum of space. Yeah, we're going in space. God, here we go. Okay. There are a minimum of 3 sphere upgrades for additional abilities helpful in carrying out the relevant work. Prior to the extravehicular activity containing the appropriate upgrades of the sphere, ES-11 will allow new firmware to be applied, enabling these features. Using a terminal or placing a request on SAM, users may combine the script compiler with all features and scripts to apply. Once applied, remain permanent and require a full reboot to remove. Right. Light, speed, and signal. Okay. Alright. So, sphere script A. This must be compiled with an appropriate compiler in the SAMOS mainframe. Okay. Script B. Alright. And script C. Data combination now available. Combine the files in the memory core, SAMOS. Okay. Combine the files in the memory core, SAMOS. So, where do I need to go? Oh, memory core E. What? Memory recovered. Okay. So, do I need to do something with this? Corrupted data. AD, search for fragments. And let's not just do this. Sphere upgrade. Wait. I don't want this. View data, connect nodes. 2 fragments remaining. That was script upgrade HVCB. What's this? EAS hatch schematic. Okay. Upgrade HVCA. Select fragment. Sphere script compiler HVC. Sphere upgrade procedure. Where's A then? Is it over here? Experiment order. Sphere upgrade procedure. Did I get all three? Sphere script compiler HVC. Experimental fusion reactor. HVC A. HVC B. EAS hatch schematic. Corrupted data. Backspace to zoom out. Hang on. Did it get everything? Experimental order. Sphere is best practice. System link reset. Compiler HVC upgrade procedure. HVC A. Okay, so the icons are different. The, Yeah. Okay. Back it up. Okay. So, yeah, I want this. No, back. Back. What did I do before? That's view data. Connect nodes. Can I not connect the nodes? Ah! Sphere compiler. Script A, script B, compiler. Do I have to do them in order? Hang on. We can do this. So that's A. View data. Okay, back it up. Connect nodes. A, there's B. Script compiler. Sphere upgrade procedure. It wants me to start here. Combine data. This is corrupted data, though. Is that not? I don't know if that's what I want. So HVCB, HVCA, and the compiler.
Great, that's you all set up. Okay, get those module clamps fixed, Sam.
A little simpler than Kubernetes. Nope, not what I want. Return to last location. Okay, what have I got to do now? Depress airlock. What isn't? Yeah, tell me about it. Airlock controls. Hold to connect. Yay! Pressure controlled. Airlock sealed. Internal hatch. Close. All right. Depress. And open.
The control panel where you can rearrange the clamps is on the outer hull of EAS 3.
On the outer hull of EAS
3. Maybe check out EAS 12 while we're out here.
Oh boy. I don't know that I want to go in there. I don't want to go out there. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. Yeah, okay, they're labeled. Thank goodness for that. Do I want to look at EAS 12? That's kind of a thing.
Sam, it's still there. We can check it out.
This is like, oh my god. Just found out I have space claustrophobia. Yeah, tell me about it. I'm like, my shoulders will not calm down right now. I am freaking terrified. this bump something? Yeah, I did. Is there something I'm supposed to be looking for in here? If I see a body, I quit. Like, for real. Please don't be a human skull. I don't think I can ever play this. This just reminds me of getting amnesia and making 15 minutes before I gave up. I've heard about amnesia. I would not play something like that. I don't think I could play something like that, even if I wanted to. That entire game just sounds freaking terrifying. I mean, we have a thing. Okay. We have data. He's going to try and work his way around the station exterior. How is that working out for you? I guess is all I can really ask. Yeah! Why am I doing this? Good stream tonight. I'm heading out. All right. Thank you for watching. I appreciate it. Hope you have a good night's sleep. Boost. Can I do that? The noises are freaking me out here. Where was I supposed to go? EAS-3? Hang on. Re-engage EAS-03 hatch clamps. Okay. So there's two.
Straight down, Sam. The controls are at the bottom of the EAS arm.
Straight down. What the hell do you mean straight? We're in space. What does straight down mean? Controls are at the bottom of the EAS arm.
Look for the controls on EAS-3.
Okay. That's 4. This is 3, right? Oh, come on. The other ones were labeled. Hull contacts. I knew that was going to happen. Talk on it. Look for the controls on EAS-3. Which one's this? They're all labeled, but not on the side that I'm on. I saw something I could interact with. All contacts. No response. Repeat last command. Well, is that... Which one is this? I honestly am not sure where I'm at right now. I keep thinking there should be a readout somewhere here, but okay, I honestly, wait a minute. So there's four, and that's two, so this has to be three. Is it these over here? Let's see. Z is up. Thud. Keep bumping into things. I'm like 99% sure. Yeah, EAS 3. So this is the right place. Hull contacts. No response. Okay. So there should be some. God, don't make that noise, game. You're freaking me out. So where are the controls then that she's talking about? Because that's what I'm supposed to be looking for, right? Is it over here? EAS 03 hatch clamps out of range. Okay. She found it. Finally. All this computational power and I got no GPS. All right, hull contact errors. Do I report this? Clamp not engaged. Clamp closed, hull contact false. Start clamp reset. Hit M for map. error. Servo off. Let's try 8. Open clamp, hold S. Actuate servo, hold W. Oh, do I have to hold all of these? This Among Us spinoff is crazy. Stop servo, release W. Close clamp, release S. Hey, we're re-engaged. Okay, cool. So I just got to do that two more times. Yeah, this whole game is sus. Gray looking sus. All right. Let's do number two. All right. Start clamp reset. Do it again. Open the clamp. Actuate the servo. Stop servo. And close the clamp. Nice. Why do I have a sneaking suspicion as soon as I finish this sequence? This thing is just going to try and throw me into space. Okay, clamp not engaged. Here we go.
That's it. The hull connection points are reading true. I think that's working. Yeah, it's working. It's gonna take a few minutes while the module connection runs its pressure checks.
All right.
Sam, while you're out there, take a closer look at the damage you detected earlier on the station exterior. What can you see?
Yeah, sure. While you're out there. was gonna say, wasn't there a solar array that got biffed? Solar array out of range. Out of range, I'm practically on top of it. Something else I should be looking at?
The solar arrays are showing evidence of torsion and stress.
Whatever this station has gone through, the arrays had no chance. Take a closer look at the China and Russian arms. The damage to the top of them looked pretty severe.
The China and Russia arms. I'm guessing this is one of them? I mean, I'm like right here. Should I not? Which arm is this? This is the China one. Not sure what it is it wants me to look at. Is this the Russian arm then? What if I do? Oh, that's not that. What if I can I sprint? I can. Sure what this is. That actually looks like it's intact. So that's the China arm. Is this the Russian arm then? Yeah, it has to be. There's the Russian flag. I'm not... So that's just the thing. I'm not sure what I'm looking for. There's that way out there. There's debris way out here, but... So here's the Russian ooze, more black stuff.
An unknown material is present at hull fracture points.
That looks like what I found in EAS-4. What the hell is it? Bring the sphere back inside and meet me in EAS-3. Let's get this hatch open. I hope to God the others are okay.
Okay, so low power levels. Let's bring the sphere back inside. Where did I get... Oh, it was over here that I got in. There it is. Sheesh. That was not at all nerve-wracking. Close the external hatch. Repressurize. That is unreal. Absolutely unreal. And I've lost power. Yeesh. All right. Well, we made it back into the ship. I think that's about as good a place as any right now to go ahead and pause and say, my goodness, that was... Oh, my goodness, this game is... Here's the thing. It's nerve-wracking, but I'm enjoying it. I'm actually enjoying this quite a bit. I guess... But I still haven't found what I'm looking for. Might need to, what do you call it? Might need to start doing some covers and stuff like that. But anyway, yeah, I think that's going to be it for tonight. You have to play to completion. I want to see how it ends. Okay, we can absolutely do that. So Observation is going to be our Thursday night game. For a while. We'll keep doing Breath of the Wild on Tuesday, unless we want to pause Breath of the Wild. I don't know. I don't know if I want to do that. I'm thinking Breath of the Wild on Tuesday, Observation on Thursday. I think that makes for a good combo. Breath of the Wild, a little bit lighter, a little bit more fun, a little bit more fantasy. This, a little bit more somewhat reality. So we'll have our fantasy on Tuesday nights and our science fiction on Thursday nights. I feel like that works. I feel like that works. So, all right, we will do that. But I think that is definitely going to be it for tonight. I only got to use my notebook once. I'm slightly disappointed, but we were able to get. I think we did a good stuff. We made good progress. We made good progress tonight, and I'm happy about that. Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and I don't know if I can. How do you resume and options? There's no save. I just realized that. I'm assuming it just picks up where it left off. That's what I'm going to assume, is it just picks up where it left off. So that's what we'll do. We'll pick up where we left off with this next Thursday. I'll be back on Tuesday for more Breath of the Wild, and we'll see if we can push that storyline just a little bit further. I think I'll let you know, as soon as I disconnected last Tuesday, I figured out what I was doing wrong, and now I know what we need to do to continue in the game. So we'll go ahead and make some more progress on that next Tuesday. But until then, keep playing games, keep having fun. I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye. Gotta get out of this.